Hey guys, welcome back to another Photoshop mockup tutorial. In this video, I'm going to show how to create a photorealistic printed t-shirt mockup. So we'll be adding a print design on a t-shirt. We'll also get this realistic effect using the displacement map. If you want to check out how to add the highlights and change the color of t-shirt, click the link on the description to check out that video. So let's go ahead and look at how to create this effect. So first of all, I'll just select these two tag and this logo design layer, delete it out. So here is our blank t-shirt. Now let's begin from the beginning. So here we go. First of all, to add a design to a t-shirt, you must have a design. So I have got a design here. I got this cohort. Let's put this design on a t-shirt. And to do that, first thing we need to do is to add a new layer. So let's say I'll add a new layer here in this group and draw out a rectangle, a bigger rectangle like this using the selection tool. And let's fill this up with control backspace. I filled it up with white color and command E, deselect the selection, and this is normal. Right click and convert it to smart object. Now open the smart object, double click on that, and now selecting this design, drag and drop it to that layer. And let's delete this background layer, and here we go, we got this core design. We'll place it around here and file, save it. So in this way we got a smart object design here. Maybe uncheck this auto selection so that I can move this around like this. Now first thing I need to do is I need to map this, and if you check it out, it's already showing some texture over this, because in the previous video I have shown you how we have created this overlay layer where we have used the layer mode linear burn, which help us getting this effect. So it has given some advantage here, but we need to do lots more for the realistic feel. So let's keep it around here, selecting this layer. I'll just keep this around here like this. So now what I want is I need to mask this corner areas, and to do that, what you need to do is just click and just bring it around here, and it will automatically mask out the region like this, because we have already got this texture layer, and we'll link this to this and we'll mask out using this. So we got this border area. Now we need more depth, so to add that, duplicate this original texture layer and let's bring this to this group. Selecting this layer, I'll just change this to normal, and let's choose some color range. So select color range and let's use this eye picker, shift selection. This is the black area, the selection area, and here we go. And let's say I'll just command D, just keep the background white and hide out this. Okay, now let's do this. So select the layer and go to select color range, and we'll select the color range here. So let's give some depth. This maybe shift, we'll keep we'll give some shadow area like this, and let's play around with this and click OK. After this, just select this layer and apply a mask and a hide of this. So we got this nice effect here. Now what we're gonna do is reduce the opacity like this, density. You can keep plain or maybe a little diffused in this area, and if you increase more, you can increase and you can add bluish tone over this area. So we'll keep it like this. And next thing we're gonna do is to add more details, we need to give some displacement map. And to get that, let's again open this texture, and what we're gonna do is we're gonna go to image adjustment level, and let's increase the level here and let's brighten it up a little bit like this. Place it like this and make it a little more softer and click OK. Let's right click and let's merge visible for now. So we got this simple image, file, save as, and save it as displacement map. We'll keep it in under freedom here and save it. And after that, let's control command Z to get back to our original, and let's hide this out. Now let's apply this to this displacement map. So I select this and go to filter distort displacement, and let's keep it around for now. Let's say 5x5 and click OK, and let's select that file displacement map and open. And it, you can see it automatically apply that. You got that nice blurry edge here. And after that, now if you see this, you can see that displacement. And you can do more displacement by adjusting the value. So if you increase the displacement, let's say 8x8, let's do this and click OK. And again, select that displacement and open. The displacement got increased. And we lost some details in our edges. So let's reduce the details. So let's say we give 4x4 and click OK. And done. Yeah. Now let's see, hide and hide. So we got that nice depth here. See, click, click. So we need this. So after adding the displacement map, we got more realistic feel here, and you can go on adjusting with this density here to give more depth. Like if you want it clear, you can keep it like that, but for realistic feel, you need to give this bluish tone over this shaded area. So to give that realistic feel. And it's very easy to replace this design with anything. So just double click on this and it will open that, and you can replace this design with anything. And fine, after that save it and it will be automatically updated in your main file. Now the next thing we need to do is to add that tag. And to create that, for example, we know that it's our tag, we need to create this. So let's create a rectangle using the same trick. Selection tool, draw a rectangle. Then after that, let's add a new layer for this and apply a color, command D to deselect, right click, convert into smart object, then double click and open it there. Now after that, let's drag in this text. I'll just drag in this text, select, let's, here it is, drag and drop, and I'll place it around here. It's text, so you can double click and change the text anytime, or you can just use the text tool and just add any other text like this. And let's delete, let me delete this background layer. Let's place this in the center, selecting all the effect here, and file, then save it. Now if you open the main file, it's there. Now command T and let's scale this down and place it around here. Let's place it around here. Let's say you want to place it there. And let's, after this we need to do some adjustments here. So we'll use wrap option to right click wrap, and let's wrap it up to make it look like it's the, it's mapped like this. So we'll give some softness and we'll give some angular rotation here. And let's say enter. So after that, we need to do more stuff here. So let's add that displacement map to this to get more realistic feel. So I'll just select this layer and go to filter, distort displacement map. And for this, let's keep 4x4 and select that image again and okay. And we got that displacement, but it's very large in number of the value. So we need to reduce the displacement value. Let's say 2x2 and let's check it out. Okay. Now if you find that your distortment is very high and you can't adjust with the displacement value here, so what you can do is to open that displacement file from your folder. So let's open that displacement file, recent displacement map file, and here we'll reduce some stuff here. So go to image adjustment level and let's reduce the brightness like this. You can just soften the level here like this, and let's see, let's use it more, save it, and file, save. And if you go to the main file and again go to displacement, okay, and click, select that image, open, your displacement value get reduced. You got much realistic feel. And let's keep it 1x1 for this. And let me check for this one. Let's say, okay, we can do some adjustments here. So let me reduce it to 3x3 and click OK. Just select that displacement map and done. So this is how you can put your any design to a t-shirt in a photorealistic way to make it look like realistic texture. In the next video, I'm going to show you how to add this realistic drop shadow and a little more highlights and the final touch up to your mock-up design. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up. And if you want more updates on design, don't forget to like, share and subscribe to this channel. Thank you.